I'm so glad I'm able to speak to you today through this video. I know I haven't been speaking to you in the last couple of months through the promised word. I was waiting on the Lord and I wanted to see the hand of God work something and then, you know, speak to you about the testimonies, about how God worked and stuff like that. So I'm sorry that I was not able to give you the word for the month for the last couple of months. Yet I realized one thing here: it is better late than never, right? But yeah, even this month I was thinking that I should probably just wait and let the new year kick in and then hear from God with the new things that He wants to communicate to us and then share with you. But I just could not escape this moment. The Lord's spirit is so heavy. He kept speaking to me and He kept quickening my spirit to understand something. You know what? This month, the month of December 2021, we have almost come to the end of the year, right? But then the year hasn't ended yet. That's a good thing, right? We have come to the end of the year and yet the year has not ended. So we are not going to pass by 2021 without seeing supernatural happening in our lives. Say an amen to that and you will receive your supernatural. Whatever that is, whatever you have been expecting, you will receive your supernatural. Just say an amen and gladly receive it. It is the Lord who spoke, and so He is so faithful to fulfill whatever He has spoken. Amen. Now build up. Cheer up, people of God. Do not give up. Right? Do not ever give up. Take heart. Don't lose it. God is faithful and He will fulfill it. And guess what He wants us to understand this month? He wanted me to tell you, max your praise. Max your praise. I'm repeating, max your praise. Which means you need to lift up your praises one more time. Let it be from the bottom of your heart. Let it be with all your energy. Let it be with all your soul. Let it be with all your heart. Let it be with all your mind. Let it be with all your spirit. Amen. The Lord wants us to lift up praises. The Lord wants us to praise Him all the time. Keep praising Him and you will see the fulfillment of God's promise. I'm challenging you and the Spirit of God is my witness. He wants me to tell you that you need to lift your praises up one more time like you have never done before and you will receive your miracle. You will receive the fulfillment of your promises. Amen. Bless God. Bless God. He is worthy of all your praises. He's worthy of all your adoration. He's worthy of your lifting up. Amen. You need to lift God up. Amen. Let anything be there. Let any kind of a challenging situation be there. That's okay. Let it be. You know, all the time we're going to face that. But our God, He is worthy to be praised. Amen. He is worthy to be praised. I just want to read one verse and then, you know, leave that with you for your thought process, for your perusal, for you to think about it. Just meditate on that one verse and you will understand what God can do through your praises. Amen. I'm going to read to you from Acts chapter 16 verses 25 and 26. About midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God. Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns unto God. And the other prisoners were listening to them. Prisoners were listening to them in their singing unto God, right? They were praising God at that moment of their imprisonment. And the other listeners, for them, it was probably for some of them it was like a crazy thing that they are doing. Like they did not understand. They might have called them stupids. That's okay. Even in times of trouble, what is your behavior? How are you going to be? You have a great God inside of you. Amen. He has never left you. He has never forsaken you. Right? And which was understood by Paul and Silas, and they were resting on God. Even in their times of imprisonment, they were resting. And that's why they were able to sing praises, sing hymns unto God. 26th verse. Suddenly there was such a violent earthquake that the foundations of the prison were shaken. At once all the prison doors flew open and everyone's chains came loose. Say an amen. Amen. Are you tied up with something? Are those chains holding you back? Are those keeping you like in a shut condition? How powerful are they? They aren't any powerful in front of the power of God. They are no match to the power of God. All you need to do is praise Him. All you need to do is lift God in your hearts and sing unto Him. Just keep on pushing in prayer. Pray until something happens. Push. Amen. Just lift your praises. Just make Him God in your praises. Amen. Yes, He is God. But is He God through your praises? Is He your God? Is He your Lord? Amen. It depends on how you want to have Him work in your lives. Yes, He is mighty. He is able. But it depends on how you want to treat Him. It depends on how you want to engage in praising Him. It depends on how you want to get Him into your job. Amen. Into your anything within God's. You may be in a tight situation. You may be in a status of imprisonment, just like Paul and Silas. But then the Lord is saying, in your praises, I will deliver you. Just lift Him up and enjoy His deliverance. This is time that we lift His praises, and we are at the end of the year. We need to thank God for everything that He has done and lift Him up so that He will work something wonderful in our lives. Amen. And this year will not end without you seeing your supernatural. Amen. Be blessed. Cheers.